VR Chat is a massively popular virtual reality social game where users can create and share their own 3D avatars and virtual worlds. One of the key features of VR Chat is the ability to take photographs. Hello everybody, I'm Echo. Today I want to talk to you about the three most common ways to take pictures in VR Chat for PC users and the difference between it: the VR Chat camera, virtual lenses, and VRC lenses. So let's go right into it. Let's start talking about the VRChat camera. The VRChat camera is the default camera that comes with the games. It allows you to adjust basic settings such as field of view, camera position, blurry background, green screen, different resolution, and a few more stuff. This is the only camera that Quest users can use, but even limited. The VRChat camera is perfect as a good start point because I already have enough to take cool pictures for social media, but of course, it's not enough for most people interested in VR photography, has something more than selfies with friends. Let's continue with VRC lenses. This is a third-party tool made by the user Hirabiki that allows you to add additional camera functions and features to the VRChat camera. It is like you have an entire DSLR or mirrorless full-frame camera. With VRC lenses, you will get things like depth of field, rule of third, levels, exposure control, autofocus, possibilities to change between sensor sizes, creative filters, green and blue screen, and a lot of more things. It's one of the most complete tools that you will find out there, but it's one of the most complicated to use too. Do all the functionalities, menus, and parameters. It is the same as when you come from your phone to a full-frame DSLR camera, just you need practice. And finally, we have virtual lenses made by the user Logic. It's pretty similar to VRC lens, with almost the same functionalities such as level, depth of field, run mode, autofocus, etc. It's actually a good competitor to VRC lens. But there are two things that are deal breakers for me to prefer VRC lenses. Both works perfectly in VR. Actually, virtual lens works awesome in VR, but that's the deal. Works only with a VR headset. Meanwhile, VRC lenses is VR and desktop compatible. Yes, you can use VRC lenses with all its functionality with mouse and keyboard, something not possible with virtual lenses, at least for now. And the last point that makes me prefer VRC lenses instead virtual lens is available only in Japanese. Meanwhile, VRC lenses is available in English. It's not a big deal, but for me, I prefer to use something that I can understand. If I have to explain you in an easy way the difference between these three systems to take pictures, imagine that the VRChat camera is your phone. You can take awesome pictures with your phone, you have the blurry background effect, a little bit of zoom, and a few more basic features. Works perfectly, but of course, your phone is not a camera. It's a phone, so it's limited, but A, it does the job. Virtual lens is something like an advanced super zoom camera, a good one, with a ton of features, but with detail that doesn't make it perfect, but way better than your phone. And VRC lenses is, of course, a high-end DSLR or mirrorless camera. VRC lens includes a lot of functionalities in comparison with virtual lenses. You can do almost everything that you can do in a real-life camera. So there you have it, the difference between the VRChat camera, virtual lens, VRC lens, and what I prefer. I repeat, what I prefer. If you like to use virtual lens or another tool that it does the job for you, that's perfect and keep using it. It's like those people who prefer Canon, Nikon, Sony, that Canon is better, Nikon is better, Fujifilm is better. The perfect camera doesn't exist. Only exists the perfect camera for you. So in that case, for me, VRC lenses is the perfect camera for what I do. Whether you are a trusted user or a new user, you must need to try VRC lens or virtual lens at least one time. Hirabiki and Logic have a world to test each one of these tools. I will leave you the link to visit their worlds and where to get their product in the description down below. I hope this video has been entertaining and useful for you, and if you want to learn more, I invite you to join my VR Photography Discord server that just opened the doors a few days ago. Thank you everybody, and I hope to see you soon for more VR photography.